And if I press W or click on the move, I can click and move my extruded spheres like this. Scale does what you would expect. It will scale up and down. I can also do the same for this main sphere like that. And rotate will rotate the limbs like this. So now let's go back to draw. I can also insert at any point. I can insert new spheres and move them around like this. So this is a very cool and neat way to create volumes. So now let me undo this and let's start again. So I'm gonna move his legs down like that. Maybe let's see. I'm gonna scale this down a little bit. So what I want to do at the moment is just to create some base proportion and volume. And you can see I can move and scale the Z spheres that I've created like this. I'm gonna move them back. Let's see. I'm just clicking the mouse and dragging it around. So what we want to do is to have something that we can expand for his legs. Now obviously this picture that we're using, it's not symmetrical, it's not from the front, so we don't need to be super precise at this stage, but let's just use this as a reference, like that. We will obviously refine the character later. So let's add a new sphere and move it down. Now let's scale this down. It has very thin ankles. Now we can add maybe one here and scale it up to create a little bit more volume for the calves and something like that. Again, I'm not worried at this time about the exact proportion. This is just to have something that we can start with. So let's move something like here. Let's bring the knee here, something like that. And so we are going to sculpt this character in a, it's called a T pose or a pose. So let you understand what I'm talking about. T pose is this. This is a kind of, the body looks like a T, a letter T. This is a T pose. This is commonly used because it's easy to model and then put the skeleton inside for the animations. So we're gonna do something like this. So I don't know, this image, it's pretty nice, but it's not official. This has been made by some other artists, but it's good to take a look what other people have done. It helps for the proportions, as you can see. But I will prefer to start using the actual images from the movie, which are the one that we are going to look at the moment. So let's go back to our character here, and let's continue. So for the feet, we are going to click on draw and extrude another sphere, and then we're going to extrude another small sphere here, and maybe move it forward a little bit, something like that. And again, I'm not worried at this point about matching the exact feet shape. I just want something to have a little bit of volume, and I will refine that later. Now let's move up. Let's create. As you can see, when I move towards the center, the cursor snaps this because I have symmetry active, and it snaps in the middle, so I don't have to worry about being super precise. The software will take care of that for me. So again, click and drag, and then I'm going to, let's see, scale it up like that, and then make another one like so. Let's bring this guy here, so it's gonna be about, this is gonna be the belly, like that. It obviously needs more volume, so we can scale this up, but again, we will take care of that more precisely later on. For now, let's add a little bit of volume like this, and place it roughly when it's supposed to be. Now, let's add the shoulder. Let's move them down like this a little bit. So he has very broad shoulder, a very heroic, stereotypical heroic figure, and kind of like that. Let's continue by adding arms like that. We're gonna extrude his big arms now. Again, I want to sculpt this character in a T pose or an A pose. The A pose is just with the arms a little bit towards down compared to T pose, but so let's do now, just to have an idea of the proportions. Let's see if let's keep this pose right now, and then we are gonna move it later. So broader shoulders, something like this, right? And then we can just add what will become the hand like that, something like this, just to have an idea this character can look like. Now maybe let's see, perhaps the legs are a little bit too short, so what we can do, just click on move and move this guy down a little bit, something like that. Maybe a little bit, even a little bit more, but again, we will change the proportions later on, refine them. Now I just want something that vaguely resembles his body shapes. But as you can see, if I move this around,